What is up, guys? My name is Winster. Welcome back to The Average Fighter. Now, today's video, we are going to have a discussion of Marvel's Capcom Infinite and E3 2018. We did have a very minuscule, small piece of information can possibly shed a little bit of light on Marvel's Capcom Infinite and its future after E3. But before we get into that, guys, make sure that you guys mash that subscribe button. Hope you guys are having a fantastic day, and let's get on with the video. This E3 has been an emotional ride. It's been too much going on, man. Reveal after reveal. I can't even think of all of them off the top of my head, but I know the ones that I'm hyped for. The Resident Evil 2 remake. Man, it's been so long since I've played the game. I am definitely going to jump back into it with all the HD gloriness, the updated graphics. Leon Kennedy looks on point, man. He looks so clean. And Leon being like a tie for my favorite character next to Albert Wesker. I love Leon. Leon is so cool. I remember playing Resident Evil 4. I do not remember playing Resident Evil 2. It's been too long. But I'm probably going to get lost and die so many times. But I'm going to jump back into it. Considering that it's also going to be released, I think, the end of this year or the beginning of next. That's so quick. You know, they were working on it. They kept it under wraps. And they're like, hey, here you go. And I'm pretty hyped about that. The Last of Us 2 gameplay. Ooh, man, it is looking real nice. I don't think the game is actually gonna play like the way they showed it, but I mean, the updated visuals on it are pretty dope. I can't wait to jump back into it. I was wondering where's Joel, because Joel's probably like my favorite character. I like how he is as a character, you know, really protective over Ellie. There's other games that have been announced. The biggest one was probably Smash. Everyone was waiting for Smash. They brought every single character from past Smash games. I've seen so many memes about Waluigi not making the cut. I guess he was a playable character at some point. I honestly can't remember. I'm not a huge Smash fan, but I like the game because it brings back a lot of memories from when I was a kid. But I'm definitely gonna jump on that. They're bringing Cloud. Ooh, that's gonna be my boy Ryu and Bayonetta, so I'm gonna be playing them. Probably play Mario because I love Mario. Mario's cool. But the biggest one of them all personally was Kingdom Hearts 3. Guys, this is the game for me, man. When I saw the trailer, all the trailers that they released, they've done two of the same trailer, which is different scenes and different pieces of information. But I lost my mind at every single one. At the end of the first one, where Aqua's possessed by Xehanort. Aquanort? I don't know. If you've heard it first here, Aquanort is her name. But that's what I'm really hyped for, and considering that they dropped the release date, it is a little bit delayed. It's gonna come out 2019. I don't care. I've already waited, you know, 10 plus years for the game. What's another month? You know, I was already expected it to show up towards the end of the year. I'm okay with waiting just a tad bit longer. But what I wanted to talk to you guys about today was a small piece of information that we got from Marvel's Capcom Infinite that could lead us to the future of where the game is possibly going to be headed to, considering that they're going to release this item, or hopefully they're going to release this item. Now, what I wanted to talk to you guys about today was the future of Marvel's Capcom Infinite. Now, believe it, there is a small piece of information that we did get about the game, and I wanted to shed some light on that, and I wanted to get you guys' opinion, start a discussion. Definitely want to keep things entertaining for you guys, considering that we did not get an official announcement from E3, from any developer, considering that E3 is almost done, and right now they're just playing indie games. I could be wrong. They're really not going to announce anything. I don't think so. I could be definitely wrong. At the filming of this video, there could be a huge announcement. Hey, Ultimate Marvel's Capcom Infinite. We did get something. We did get something very interesting, that is. So this piece of information has been floating around for quite some time now. People at Capcom or Disney have yet to release, but it's been floating around as a prototype, and that is the Marvel vs. Capcom Fight Stick. It is the Razor Fight Stick with just the Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite decal. It does pay homage to Marvel vs. Capcom Superheroes or Clash of Superheroes, and it has everyone standing in a circle around the joystick, so that's pretty cool. I like that they're paying respects to what came before it. But this brings a very interesting discussion on the actual detailed information about the stick. It does say coming soon. Now, this was retweeted by Markman. I think he was the first to put it out. I could be definitely wrong, but that's who I saw it first. And considering that he works very close with Mad Cats, I don't know where he's currently residing, but he's probably someone well informed of what could possibly happen. And he did tweet it out. So it leads me to believe that this is probably going to get released, considering that it said coming soon. That leaves us in a very interesting situation with Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite, is since nothing really was released, nothing has really come other than like one update. And not too long ago, we got a very small update on the game. A lot of people were feeling very indifferent, like the game is gonna die, they're already removing this, you know, there's no hope left. But also, now that the stick is floating around, it did say coming soon. Is there a chance that Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite is gonna get more information coming out? And it's very strange, considering this was shown at E3. It just puts us in a very strange predicament. We don't know what's going on with Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite. We don't know if something is going to come up. Now, there has been some rumors that there's going to be an update at the end of the year, maybe towards October, November, sometime in between there. There is a couple of months from now, 4 or 5 months. It does leave me very hopeful. If this is going to be coming out from Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite, what's the likelihood that something else is going to be coming out? Considering that I'm pretty sure they would need approval from like Capcom and Disney to have something be released like this. Now, again, guys, I could be completely wrong. I could completely be crazy and not know what I'm talking about. But it does bring up interesting discussions. I want to know what you guys think, considering that the stick more than likely will come out, because it does say coming soon and it was retweeted by someone very close who works with Capcom. I definitely want to get your guys' opinion on it. What do you think the likelihood of this stick coming out? More information does shed a little bit of light of what could be a possibility, and I wanted to know what you guys think. Let me know what you guys think about the stick, and let me know what you guys think about any more information for Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite. Definitely would love to read those. Leave it in the comments below, guys, of what you think. This was just a small discussion. Let me know, guys. And with that being said, my name is Winster. This is The Average Fighter, and I will check you guys out later.